Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, we are from Group 2. Martin Othniel, Muhammad Kurnia Agung, and me, Muhammad Tanjipan Fadlan, are the member of this group. Today we are going to present about presenting reputation risk, PT PLN company in overcoming blackout on the island of Java. Chapter 1. Background. Externally driven incidents. Acts of terror or sabotage. Political insurrection. Pandemic health fears and acts of nature are all incidents that require operational and communication response. There are many examples of organizations mismanaging an accident that they had no control over, and as a result, their reputation had declined. Next, attacks on you or those in your care. It is these externally driven incidents that put organizations in the most spotlight in terms of response. As a direct target of planned attack, organizations must protect their people, their customers, their assets, their business. This kind of attack happens suddenly and unexpectedly. Many organizations have specific plans for situations such as kidnapping, hijacking, and sabotage, and will train them in the crisis drills. Any argument that the organization mismanaged the response can turn sympathy into hostility very quickly. This can be a difficult reality to deal with, especially when the accident is taking place. A new form of attack from an external incident. The threat of malicious cyber attack or a seriously damaging cybersecurity breach has come one of the most talked about externally driven incidents. As more and more multinational companies face attacks on their database, email system, and websites, the cyber era brings with it new risks and threats for both individuals and organizations. They must protect their data and intellectual property or IP in order to survive and remain competitive. Piracy, return of the old form of external attack. In the recent years, while cyber attack have risen on the list of risks, a form of attack that has existed for centuries has created unwanted backlash. Efforts to reduce the risk of piracy have been at an unprecedented level of international cooperation. The most important development is increased use of armed private security guards on ships, a measure that has helped to significantly reduce the threat. Attacks against a wider group that affects you. Piracy incidents such as cyber attack are targeted at one organization for a specific reason, financial gain, or access to valuable information for the purpose of financial gain or causing disruption. For an organization, the key lies in predicting what could happen, staying alert to prevent attacks, and preparing for the worst, all as part of broader city or national resilience effort. Political or social development that endanger you or those in your care. A third type of external incident is a sudden political or social development, while not targeted at you, put those in your care at risk. As with any form of external incident, there is the potential for chaos and confusion, and you have a little or no control over the resolution. The characteristic that makes his situation different is that it is a highly political and volatile risk situation. A sudden threat to the political status quo in a region, country, or region is something the security department has to plan. There will be also a need for strong human research and communication response if there is a realized.
Okay, next is a natural event. The last type of external incident driven risk from differ the others in the chapter in that volatility and threats are natural, not man-made. As discussed in the previous chapter, people feel differently about man-made risks than natural ones. Even the weather events can wreak more havoc than bombs, and pandemic flu outbreaks can kill more than revolution, then incidents can occur without warning. Next, internally driven incidents. Sudden self-inflicted incidents that harm people, your community, or the environment are a nightmare for any organization. Senior leaders fear knocks on the doors, phone calls, or interrupted meetings to tell them a facility has exploded, a ship capsized, or a plane crashed and people lost their lives. Next is 10 safety incidents that shape crisis management today. First is Bhopal, heading to the scene. Second is Piper Alpha, major incidents require relative media and response capability. The Third is action Valdez. If you don't act, regulators and politicians will act. The fourth is Pan Am. Companies can be victims. The fifth is Swiss Air. Families can forgive if you help them remember it. The sixth is Herald of the Free Enterprise. Never speculate. Seven is Deepwater Horizon. Spokespersons is important. Eight is Midland. Please Midland. Reputation can be built with good crisis response. The nine is Hudson River. Crisis needs some heroes. And the last one is Texas City. Crisis management is about action as well as words. Next is internal communication and incidents. It is reasonable to assume that the problem in the form of crisis that the most threaten the reputation of an organization, that something catastrophic has occurred, or that it appears to be the fault of the organization itself, and then has potentially devastating consequences for the people and/or the environment. There must be an anger, blame, reputational damage. The crisis management case is PT PLN Company in overcoming blackout on the island of Java. On the edges 4, 2019, PT PLN experienced a crisis caused by the non-functioning of three short simultaneously, which in the end of simultaneous power outage in several provinces, including Banten, DKI Jakarta, and West Java. This power outage occurred for 18 hours, causing losses, and the big impact of this blackout is cessation of the flow of economy in affected city. Considering the electricity is the main source of the energy in order to run the economy. The most common example is where the banking system use ATMs, which of course use electrical energy source. Apart from the economic side, the impact was also felt by the industrial sector where the production machines stopped due to power outage. The impact of this blackout was also felt by the general public where all form existing equipment and furniture use a lot of electrical energy. The case certainly garnered a lot of attention, especially from President Joko Widodo. President Joko Widodo expressed his disappointment with PLN over the case. He expressed disappointment with PLN because it was considered not to swift overcoming the system damage that occurred on edges 4, 2019 in Pemalang and Ungaran. With the blackout lasting for 18 hours, President Joko Widodo also stated that the long time was proof that the PLN response to the crisis was not optimal. The president deeply regrets this because PLN itself is only the company that handles electricity service in Indonesia. The SWOT analysis or SWOT analysis is used to measure the company's strength, weakness, opportunity, and threats to the crisis at hand. By looking at the strength they have continued to develop them, the company's ability to overcome crisis or problem will also increase. Likewise, with the weakness, that must be analyzed and continuously improved so that the company can continue to exist. Opportunity must also be seen by the company when facing problems, so then companies can more easily find solution in a time of crisis. Threat that will be faced by company must be faced developing a good marketing strategy.
Chapter 2. Crisis Management Perspective, SWOT, and Case Race. SWOT analysis includes efforts to analyze the strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats that determine the company's performance. External information about opportunities and threats can be obtained from many sources, either from existing data and so on. Strength. In terms of strength of the crisis experienced by PT PLN, is in this crisis, PT PLN is responsible for planning compensation due to the many loss caused by the blackout. Directors of PT PLN said it would cut the salaries of the employees by 40,000 rupiah to pay compensation for loss to the affected communities. Weakness. In terms of weakness, PT PLN looks unprepared to handle the crisis. PT PLN is also unable to communicate properly to the people affected by the blackout. Opportunity. In terms of opportunities, PT.PLN has the opportunity to improve or create a good image of the company going forward in dealing with future crises. Threats. In terms of threats, PT.PLN is threatened to have a bad image in the community due to the poor handling of the crisis and the lack of communication to the people affected by the power outage. Rating perspective. Basically, all technology certainly has a risk for a crisis to occur, but a crisis can also be seen as a life cycle in a company or organization. A crisis is not something that is considered an anomaly, but is part of the part that companies or organizations must face to survive. In this case too, the crisis can be identified as a lesson that can certainly be taken by the company or organization to keep growing. Because in the previous view or perspective, the crisis was considered as a life cycle in the company or organization, then the crisis will not always be seen as a negative thing. In crisis management, the role of public relations is very important to build interaction with the public sphere, which must always be improved. Chapter 3. Closing. Conclusion. Conclusions can be drawn from the discussion in the previous chapter regarding crisis management experience by PLN companies. As previously explained, a disaster crisis from a company can happen anytime, anywhere, and whether the incident or crisis is caused by factors due to poor company or organization communication or external factors such as natural events or natural disaster. Of course, in a swift and appropriate handling, careful preparation are needed regarding incident or crisis that will occur repeatedly. Careful plans are needed in dealing with a crisis that cannot be predicted when it will occur. Therefore, it is not a matter of when the crisis will occur, but how prepared the company or organization is to face the crisis that will occur without warning or prior notification. Suggestion. Companies or organizations should be able to prepare for handling all possible crises that will occur through crisis management, because the future of the company or organization is also determined in how a company or organization deals with a problem. All preparation and handling should have become option that can be swiftly take when a crisis occurs that is never unexpected, but because of its unpredictable nature, every company or organization should have prepared all handling in accordance with the risk in every aspect and sectors that are in the system of the company or organization. That's all from us. Thank you for watching.